Okay, now we move into this topic of the time management tools. So the identifying these activities are really a critical part of being able to apply the tool. Without identifying activities, we cannot, there's not much we can actually manage. Okay, so here I've listed some of the common tools which are around, and we will be covering quite a few of these, but I'm starting with the basic one, lists or a calendar. Do we consider calendar as a time management tool? It is.
It is.
Most basic. A diary is a time management tool. Okay. We will go on to bar charts and Gantt charts. Okay, that's in the next lecture. It is a slightly more sophisticated way of time management. Go into critical path method. Gets even more involved, a little more detailed than bar chart. Go into something like program evaluation review technique or PERT. Now you're getting a little probabilistic. Monte Carlo simulation, again more again probabilistic and representing uncertainty. Linear scheduling method or location based management system. Okay, now you are bringing in a slightly different view to scheduling. Theory of constraints, a dependency structure matrix, the list goes on. The challenge again here, which tool do I use for which job? Right. So a lot of times it's tempting to use a complex tool for a even a simple job, saying because of the what do you say, the charm in using a complex tool. So we have seen many projects in which the team would say, oh, I would like to use PERT because it's probabilistic modeling and I have a lot of uncertainty in my project, so I want to use a more sophisticated technique, but might not be justified. Or I want to use Monte Carlo simulation because it really simulates my project, but the overhead of running Monte Carlo simulation, overhead of getting data to run Monte Carlo simulation just really does not justify the using the tool. So the utility of the results you get out of it is just not there. Okay, so the rule we should probably use here is use the simplest tool which can get your job done. And this again is not how would you say it, it's not that simple to execute. You have to actually develop a good judgment of what is the right tool for your kind of work. Any questions or suggestions or points on this? Okay, let's go to this simple tool. How many of you do lists? Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Everyone's good time management people. Okay, everyone does lists. So, yeah. Okay, you do the list and you don't follow the list. Okay, so you can see lists have been around for a long time. Okay, you used to get the old paper form of the list where you were supposed to do a to-do list. Okay, you can see it there. You know, the last one is probably what is the best to-do list, right? Nothing to do all the time, so you just scratch it out and you're done. And you can see now this is transformed from paper to your smartphones, computers, everything, your Outlook, you know, Google Calendar, what everything is, so you know, Google has a task list. So this to-do list is a very common part of our time management tool. Does it really do time management? What is the time dimension in the to-do list?
Just start activities are there, that's all.
Is there a time aspect to the to-do list?
If you associate the deadlines with them, then yes.
If you put to-do on a calendar, then there is a time aspect to it. If you do to-do without a calendar, basically there is, yeah, in this window of time you need to do so many things. There is a kind of an implied time management in it, but basically what is a list now? The list are activities which you have to achieve something which you want to in that week or in that day or whatever. So you are doing activity identification, you are listing the activities, you are not putting specific time on of it, all of it. Okay. And like I said, we do the list, but a lot of times you're doing the planning, you're not doing the monitoring or the control. okay, or you are doing the planning, you are doing the monitoring and control only in the very, very, very last minute, okay, which tends to upset your other plans. Now, what is the difference between a to-do list and a calendar? So, the calendar certainly has, you have a time dimension on your activity now, and the time dimension, again it is a single time dimension usually, saying that you are going to start, you have the start, typically on a calendar we enter on this day I do this, you do not, you might have a duration also, okay. So, that is what the calendar, and again the calendar has gone from its paper form to highly sophisticated electronic forms, okay, that will do all kinds of things for you if you are willing to do. So, I would like to take this discussion now back to our earlier example, which tool would you use for what, or do you need something more sophisticated? Take the industrial lecture, what is the tool you would use? Is a to-do list enough, or how would you actually, now I am getting into a little more detail. Last time we identified the activities. Calendar for industrial lecture, what would you do on the calendar?
Starting from communication from the lecture
speaker has to be confirmed by this date.
Right, yeah. So you would take dates and you would say that what you could do on each date, what you should achieve by each date would be done. You would also probably say when should I start something, and by when should this be taken care of. Say you want to do an industrial lecture scheduled by let's say 2 weeks time, you want to arrange for a lecture in 2 weeks time, 2 weeks from today, what is the duration of your activities? Or to what level of detail would you plan? Daily or hourly?
During the lecture, it should be hourly basis.
Yeah, during the lecture. So, as you get closer to the lecture, that is you are going to a level 5 schedule, it will be hourly. That means refreshment should arrive at a specific time, lecture should start at a specific time, should end this, that, all of that would be, you know, the taxi should pick up the speaker at a specific time, it would be hourly. Or even to the minute, okay. But I should send the letter out, invitation letter should go. Does it need to be hourly? No, it can be daily, probably you can't have a week, it can be daily. It should go by this day, it does not matter if it goes, I mean, should not matter if it goes by 9 o'clock or by 5 o'clock, by this day I should send it, okay. You are giving enough of a buffer on that for various uncertainties on that, but a day is enough, but you cannot afford to use a day in the finer details. When you go to the last part of your lecture, you cannot afford to use a day, okay. So, calendar is okay, and not being so complex, you can still write down the schedule in a written form, you do not need that. When you get into, only thing, your calendar has got finer, your calendar has gone from a daily calendar to a hourly calendar as you get to the final sequence of the lecture. When you go into field trip, it is same calendar, CFS, lot of it is calendar, calendar can take a lot of preliminary activities, but the challenge now is you are going to have multiple activities looking at for the same resource. So, a hall will be required by 3-4 events. So, I cannot afford to just say okay, hall is available, I cannot afford, can I plan the events independently? No, I have to plan it in sequence. So, you will actually need something little more sophisticated than a calendar, yeah, something like a Gantt chart which we will cover, okay. But yes, you can do it to the calendar with color coding, this, that, everything, you could use it, but we are looking for something more sophisticated. When you go to something like Shastra, again something like a Gantt chart would be, or a bar chart would be adequate, you do not need anything far more sophisticated, okay. So, this is what we are going to cover in the next class, which is Gantt charts. We will understand how Gantt charts, a bit of the history and how it is developed, but meanwhile what I would ask you to do is to actually take up any upcoming project you are involved with, okay. Think we know whether it's an exam that's coming, okay, preparation for an exam and resulting in an exam, or whatever you would like to think, whatever is coming up in the next 1 month, there will, you'll certainly be involved in some project or the other. I know some of you will be involved with CA Fest, okay. Develop the work breakdown structure with the following aspects in mind. What are the time related objectives? Okay, what is level of activity details is appropriate? What are the alternative structures for the work breakdown structure? Okay, which structure is more appropriate for you and the team? And the critical thing is to be able to identify, organize activities needed to plan, communicate and control the deliverables of the project from time perspective. We're looking only from the time perspective here, not the cost or anything else. Okay, so I would like you to discuss, to kind of think about this, and we will discuss it in the continuing session.